Welcome to Wager Talk TV. I am Kelly Stewart, joined by SportsMemo.com master handicapper, NFL better extraordinaire, Teddy Covers, at Teddy Covers. If you guys aren't following him on Twitter, he may have more followers than me, even though I just hit over 30,000. I was pretty excited about that. But
31.5.
That's what I thought.
Teddy underscore Covers.
Teddy underscore. Guys, do not forget that underscore because it's really important. Teddy didn't want to buy Teddy Covers.
No, the whole way I got on Twitter was because someone went in and started tweeting as Teddy
you.
Covers. And I'm like, well, I better get to figure out what's going on. And I couldn't even lodge a protest until I went on and created an account. So that was the first thing I did the first night when I joined was Teddy underscore Covers. And
that's
great. That's what I got.
And the rest is history. Okay, let's talk about NFL. It's insanity to me that it's week 14.
Let's talk about NFL.
It's insanity to me that it's week 14. I can't even feel like it is. Baltimore Ravens at the Kansas City Chiefs. Chiefs now down to 6.5. Mm-hmm. I like this Chiefs team when it was at 7. Listen, Lamar Jackson's been playing great ball for the Ravens this past 3 weeks. 3 wins. Maybe we get Joe Flacco. Maybe we get Jackson. I'm not sure it matters. I still think Justin Tucker is the best offensive player for that team. By the fact that he's been able to kick a few field goals and get me in the money. That being said, Chiefs defense, little suspect.
Well, when you understand why the money's coming in on Baltimore, and it's been heavy money, you know, there were 8s in some place at the open, down to 7.5, boom, 7, through the 7 to 6.5, pretty much across the board. You know, that doesn't happen with chump change. This has been a significant wise guy move on Baltimore, and you look at the defensive numbers, you can understand why. On a yards per play basis, the Ravens, the best defense in the NFL, and it's really not even close. And Kansas City, about, I think it's 1.4 yards per play worse on the defensive side of the football. You don't often see that type of a disparity with teams that are a touchdown plus underdogs. All that being said, and there was something else that we have to talk about last week with Kansas City not covering. The Chiefs don't have the betting bandwagon they did a month ago.
Absolutely not.
They've only covered 1 point spread, that game at Cleveland, in the last 5. You know, they did get the money in Monday night, you know, in the Monday night game at L.A.
Yep.
But even in that game, there wasn't a ridiculous amount of Chiefs money. That was two-way action and, of course, not covering again last week. And they were up 3 scores in Oakland and fell asleep. It happens.
And they have drama surrounding some of the other stuff.
Sure.
And you know, I'm sorry, West, where whoever's going to be the starting running back this week is not Kareem Hunt. They just aren't. And it just is the truth.
And bingo. When you look at some of the throws that Patrick Mahomes was making last week against Oakland's defense, you know, throwing late across his body over the middle, he's the only quarterback in the NFL that's making those throws. Is that going to work against Baltimore's defense? You know, the wise guys are saying very clearly that they don't think that, you know, remember in preseason, all we were hearing was reports of Mahomes throwing picks in practice and all through training camp. This is the kind of defense that might create some problems like that for a Kansas City team that hasn't really been on the negative end of the turnover differential very often this season. All that being said, Kelly, Lamar Jackson playing from behind, not a chance I trust him to do that. No way.
This is the one thing that I really put in some stock. The Chiefs have been on the road a lot lately, and then they also had a bye week, so that kind of stretches things out. This is their first game back in Arrowhead in almost a month. And I know we don't put a lot of stock into home field advantage in the NFL like we do in college football. Mm-hmm. But Arrowhead is a tough place to play. They're going to be rocking. They're excited for the Chiefs to come back. And I think that's got to give that extra little edge to Kansas City there.
And conceptually, last 3 weeks, Baltimore gets an Atlanta team that just had their season ended. They had a Raiders team that I understand they gave KC a battle last week. They gave Baltimore a battle, too, in Baltimore. That game was very misleading. Two non-offensive touchdowns for the Ravens in that contest. And then the week before, they have Cincinnati.
And look what Denver did at Cincinnati. Let's be honest.
Exactly. This three-game winning streak for the Ravens may be a little bit fraudulent. Some of those defensive stats may not be quite as real. If I'm playing, I'm laying. Chiefs are pass.
I like it. Good stuff. I like when Teddy covers, and I agree. Make sure you guys head over to SportsMemo.com and check out Teddy's stuff. And are you guys a member of the Sports Memo Text Club? It's 100% free. Just text Sports Memo to 33222 to get a $10 welcome bonus for just signing up, plus free picks and other text club offers.